Hi, I'm Julie.
I'm Robbie.
We're hitting the road to meet folks from all over the state who are feeling the effects of climate change.
We're also going to meet people who have found real solutions.
Join us as we meet a farmer out in Grant County.
My name is Jim Baird. I've been farming here in the Columbia Basin for 40 years. I've got two sons. I farm about 1,000 acres.
We feed a lot of people from this little bread basket. Apples go to 70 different countries. Our wheat goes around the world.
Jim hasn't always been an organic farmer. When he started out, he used all the conventional techniques.
I got sucked in. We do like to kill weeds. We do like to control insects. I really knew that organic farming just made more intuitive, common sense about what was best for the soil and best for the food.
But lately, he's been dealing with some big changes.
We have been talking about this wave of climate change coming for a long time, and we are just going to be learning how to adapt.
When we first met Jim 6 months ago, climate change was about as spooky to him as a scarecrow in a pink dress.
Now, however, climate change is starting to look more like this guy.
That's scary.
It's scary.
We've always been known for big winds, and we've always had hailstorms, but I would say that the frequency and the intensity of them has really magnified in the last couple of years. One of our biggest problems out here is wind erosion. Well, our soil, if we don't treat it right, can also start blowing a lot. We're seeing plants react differently. The fruit doesn't store as well.
The magnitude of the change has been putting our harvest dates weeks to months earlier than normal.
That's a lot of changes. I think I'm having a panic attack.
Oh, but don't hyperventilate. Jim's got solutions. For example, plants need nitrogen, but it takes a lot of energy to manufacture fertilizers. So Jim just grows his own right here on the farm.
In this field, we're growing a legume. Legume plants pull nitrogen out of the atmosphere. We can grow up to 100 to 150 pounds of nitrogen just from our plants here.
My favorite part of the crash course, Jim dashed off to show us how organic farmers cope with pests.
Those are called insectary zones. We grow like 10 or 15 different kinds of flowers to attract native pollinators and beneficial insects.
Okay, so he grows his own fertilizers, he attracts his own pollinators, but how does he cope with weeds?
Biofumigation. And what we're growing here is a mustard crop. We flail chop it and then immediately till it right into the soil. And it gives off a gas effect, just like mustard gas. And it's going to kill weed seeds.
By building his own healthy soil, Jim draws carbon out of the atmosphere and keeps it in the ground. Climate change is bringing farmers together. The good news is organic methods really help, and Jim is thrilled that more and more of his conventional farm neighbors are starting to use organic methods.
We as farmers are the stewards of our society's food source, and so it's behooving to us to continue to work on growing healthier and healthier food.
And as consumers, we should ask questions about how our food is grown. Local farmers markets are a wonderful place to do that.
This unflappable farmer, whose brain is just overflowing with science and technology, really gave us hope.
Will you feed us?
Wait, if we can.
I'm giving serious consideration to
Okay.